How are you guys doing today? My name is Anima and today we have a live Pokemon ORAS Wifi battle for you all this time against Joba! Joba, thank you for accepting my challenge over Twitter. That is how you challenge me, ladies and gentlemen. We're at a bit of an angle here, so it's kind of freaking me out. I feel like we're in space. No, we're not. We're in my bedroom. Budget cuts. Anyway, Joba, your Twitter link will be in the description down below. So folks, if you enjoy this battle, do go and check him out, as well as his YouTube if he has one. Joba, let me know if I've forgotten. There will be a question of the day at the end of the video. Can we get this video to an almighty total of 200 whopping great fat L's? Likes? Because that would be awesome. But if not, that's okay. Make your decisions at the end of the video, folks. Of course, after watching. Unless you want to be a complete rebel and like it right now. A few of you have gotten on board with saying that you're like a rebel and liking it right now, and I think that's so cute and funny. Thank you guys, it's really, really nice. Anyway, this is a very festive team that I am using, hence the festivities. No, I just dressed like this. This is like my business attire. Let's write down his team so that, you know, we have a chance. I basically just said, bring whatever you want, I don't care. So we're just gonna, because I'm not taking this seriously, we're just gonna like try and see how we go. This is the team that I, if I've been a good egg, I would have posted the team building video, and it will be in the description as well. This is kind of just like a, we're just sort of messing around and being festive, okay? So, and of course, submit your any changes you think this team should have. Anyway, let me let you know who I bought. I bought Broccoli, the Trevenant, Little Helper, the Scrafty, Hanukkah, the, this is funny, Chandelure Blitzen, the, oh goodness, Sourcebook, Christmas, the Sceptile, and Santar, the Delibird. So, there has been some tweaks since the video, since the team building video that I did do. We don't have hazards, so this is giving me a bunch of strange options as to who to lead with. I kind of feel like leading with Little Helper, but also Broccoli. I feel like Broccoli is a pretty, pretty powerful lead. Ooh, who are you gonna lead with though? Weavile, maybe. wow, the Weavile just fucks up my team. Anyway, let's lead with Broccoli. I feel like Broccoli is okay. The Weavile wrecks my team so much, especially if it has like low kick or something. My Scrafty is not going to appreciate dealing with that Molover. And if it knocks off my Citrus, well then shit. But we'll just have to deal with that. Out comes the Emolga. I didn't actually expect him to lead with his Weavile for some inane reason, even though that would have been the best decision, I think, for my whole team. But him not leading with his Weavile kind of tells me that it's not a Sash Weavile. So out comes Emolga, and this thing could have Taunt. It could have Taunt. So I'm honestly fearing that. So I am fearing the Taunt, to tell you the truth. So I do actually feel like going into my Little Helper, because I think that the Taunt is coming. Because it's like a lead Emolga and Trevenants like to burn things. So we're going to go into Little Helper, my specially defensive wall of the team. We are like Max Spadoof with Assault Vest and Shed Skin. There's the Taunt, as I thought. And now we're in here with my very specially defensive demon. But we are also adamant natured, so it's kind of like a bit mysterious. There have been alterations to the sets that I've posted, but not really as much to Little Helper. We've just made her more defensive. So what we're gonna do is we get a free knockoff. Oh, Glade. we don't quite get a free knockoff, I'm afraid. But you know, it's not, do we get a free knockoff is the real question. Because I strongly feel like, I feel like he might go into Glade, but then that's also sort of a bit risky. I do want to go for the knockoff real bad. I'm probably overthinking it so much. But Glade is just such a switch in for this, that I'm actually going to go for the Zen Headbutt. Because, oh fuck, so it's got U-turn, which is interesting. So it's probably, so it's a physical Emolga, that didn't do anything. So I'm actually expecting Glade to come in right now to take the knockoff and get a justified boost. I said just bring whatever you want, so I don't know, you know. Outcomes Knock Me Off, who is the Glade, and I did expect this, which is why we went for Zen Headbutt. So we're gonna do super effective damage, which is so fucking nice. Getting a critical hit. Thank you, Hax. Are you gonna be nice to me lately? I'm sorry, I've been on about Hax so much, guys. I'll try to stop, it's just been really winding me up. So out comes this mole lover. And what we're going to do is quickly look at Delibird's stats and just see if our speed isn't completely pathetic. If this is Mega Gallade, then it's pretty pathetic. Gallade, you're 80, right? You're 8. You're 80. You're base 80. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus Christo. I don't feel safe. Basically, I really want to go into Hanukkah. I think that would be pretty cool. But if he goes for a knockoff, I am L fucked. But I don't think he can. I don't know. I feel like going into Hanukkah. I really do. I don't think he's just gonna. But it's so obvious. It's so obvious. And one knockoff from Gallade will sort out Hanukkah. We won't have any Hanukkah. There'll be no Hanukkah. Either way, a close combat is coming. I think broccoli is less useful than Hanukkah, so we're gonna go into broccoli because Hanukkah needs to come in with as least damage as possible. If this thing goes for a knockoff, Hanukkah's fucked. No more Hanukkah, and you know that's bad. So out comes the Mega Gallade. Oh Jesus! What tier is Mega Gallade in? Even the tiers are all crazy right now, aren't they? So there's the EQ, super. Oh my god, that is amazing. So that EQ tells me he doesn't have knockoff, so it was really good that we went into broccoli. Now, does he have anybody who particularly enjoys getting burnt? No, he does not. Does he have any grass types? Absolutely not. So what we're going to do, he does not want to get burnt, so we are going to go for the ye olde leech seed on the switch. Let's hope that we get something cool. He doesn't want to switch in something that will get burnt. I'm expecting Porygon Z. And honestly, I don't like that. I'm not really sure how to deal with the Porygon Z, but either way, I don't know who he's going to switch into. Out comes Real Bulk, so that's a Golbat. Shady Penguin there, we're having a very Shady-themed sort of situation here. You're so big, Shady Penguin! You'll never watch this video because you're such a busy man, but we all love you. So we're going to get a little bit of health from the Seed of Leeching, and I don't think this thing can take me out with a Brave Bird in the slightest because I'm a fucking piece of broccoli and I don't give a shit. So what we're going to do is, because we're here, he can't kill me with a Brave Bird unless he's offensive. So we're just going to go for the Will-O-Wisp. We can, if we proc our Citrus, then we'll be totally cool anyway. I don't know if I'm using that. How embarrassing. I don't think I'm using that term right. So he is going to withdraw because he doesn't want to have the Citrusy thing. Out comes Dragon Slayer with Porygon. Oh, Weavile. Land, 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 land. Yes. Yes! Okay, I am delighted. So, if you couldn't tell. Now let's see. You are a problem, but honestly, my little helper can mess you up something awful. This thing is so bad. He needs to go for the dark type move in all seriousness. If he goes, anything this thing does is going to hurt me so much. But I feel like going into Little Helper just because we can cope with this thing the best and we can punch something as well. So what we're going to do is we are going to go into, oh, I really want to drain punch something though. Is Little Helper the best switch in for me right now? I can't stay in, I really can't, but I'm seriously fearing a low kick from this thing, and Little Helper can't sit and take hits all day. Or do I stay in and be a complete rebel? I think I can live anything it does, so what I'm actually going to do is just go for the Horn Leech, because he might SD, predicting the switch, so bollocks, he's going to go for the knockoff, that's going to get rid of my Citrus Berry, which is extremely sad. But I don't know how it works with the Citrus situation, I don't know if I'll get it back. But either way, we're going to do good damage to it. And I wonder if Harvest will work at all. It'll do less damage with the next knockoff. So if we can get rid of this Weavile, that is a gigantic threat, absolutely removed from the team. So he can go bollocks. He can go for the Ice Punch now. So what we're going to do is go into damn, that Ice Punch. What's stronger? Well, the knockoff is stronger than Ice Punch is. So what we're going to do, we're just going to Horn Leech again. Oh, he's going to go for knockoff again. That's weaker this time. Live, Broccoli! That's my girl. That's my Broccoli. Broccoli is like, I don't think I've really used her on the channel yet, so it's pretty strange, all things considered. Well, now I'm a bit upset because Broccoli is really weakened, but we did take out this Weavile, which is a ginormous threat to my team. But to be honest, it was fucked as soon as it got burnt. So, pretty great. Anything can come out right now. Oh, die. Okay. Alright then. So this thing is honestly really just a threat. Now, I believe we can probably just sack... Well, I don't know if we can recover Broccoli anymore, really. So what we're going to do, we're just going to sack Broccoli and get the safe switch into Little Helper. So just in case you miss your focus, it goes for something weird, I'm just going to, you know, stay in and leech seed. But, you know, the Ice Beam is there and Broccoli is going to go down. But she did work! You did good work, Broccoli! Sprouts is more Christmas-orientated, but what are you going to do? What are you going to do? So let's go into Little Helper right now. And now let's see. I would love to go for a Drain Punch. I really would. Knock Off isn't that great, I don't think. I mean, is it Scarfed though? Are you Scarfed? I have no idea. I can't tell anything from whatever damage it was doing. I am actually Shed Skin, so I'm not afraid of being burnt anyway if the Cofagrigus wants to come in. So what I'm going to do is go for the Drain Punch straight off the bat. I think he might actually stay in. Gallade doesn't want to come in on a potential Zen head, but he knows that I can do that. He knows that that's the first thing I did when I saw Gallade. And Gallade switching in to take extra damage is not that amazing. He doesn't want Golbat to get knocked off. I think Cofagrigus is probably... Cofagrigus or staying in are probably his best decisions, but I'm not completely sure. I might be maybe going to Molga, actually. But even so, I feel like I should have gone for knockoff. I should have fucking gone for knockoff. Ugh, idiot. But, you know, I didn't want this thing to potentially, like... Why didn't I go for knockoff? That's really stupid of me. He's gonna withdraw die. Should have gone for knockoff. I really should have. That was really dumb. And goes into Emolga, but I wanted my health, you know. So we're gonna go for the Drain Punch. And that is fairly decent, you know, that's alright. We're gonna get our health back, and that was one of my main concerns. So this thing is here. And what do you honestly want to do? You can't do anything but U-turn. So I don't care that much. Or U-turn or like Wild Charge, because you seem to be physical. Emolga's physical stat is not brilliant. I feel like going for the... Can you take... Right, let's just have a look here. Let's just have a look and see. So we're going to pretend with the UU bulk up set because the EVs are sort of similar. And Emolga. Honestly, I do feel like we might take it out, but like, I don't know. No, nah, we won't take it out with a knockoff or whatever. We might do something with an Ice Punch, but I think he's probably just going to U-turn. Is he going to U-turn? I don't know. What are you going to do? Well, if I were you, I would just U-turn into something else. So I'm just going to go for the... you can't touch me. I'm just going to go for the knockoff. As he nuzzles me, so wow, I super don't mind. Gets the critical hit as long as we don't get paralyzed. But we don't get paralyzed, which is great. So we're going to get this knockoff off and ooh, it's going to live with just a poo of health. Which is tragic. Now what we're going to do is just go for the Drain Punch just in case he wants to switch out or something. We might be able to snag just a bit of health. So that's going to be the logic here. I feel Little Helper is going to be the only reason I'm going to be able to succeed in this game at all. So with this team at all. Well, Little Helper and predictions and my brain. So the Tailwind has gone up. We have two more turns of Tailwind to beat. And Gallade under Tailwind support. Goodness fucking gracious. That's honestly the worst thing I've ever heard in my life. So we're going to get cured of our paralysis though. So I'm pretty glad I got Shed Skin on there. It's honestly pretty nice. Intimidate is really great, but... But I'm a plebeian. So we need to make some sacrifices. Right, you can just go for close combat and... Oh, Delibird. Delibird's looking like the easiest sacrifice right now. I'm gonna go to Delibird. I'm sorry, Delibird. You just look like the easiest sacrifice right now. I'm truly, truly sorry. We have got to stall out the Tailwind, otherwise we are screwed. And I need my Scrafty. also to knock off the goal, but this is a neutral hit, but Daddy Bird is frail, so I think it might just die. He just evaporated. Awesome.
Awesome.
So, we're gonna faint, which is very, very tragic. Goodbye, Daddy Bird. See you next year. And now what we're gonna do is go into... what can we do? Under Tailwind, I really think we're gonna struggle. We're gonna go... I feel like I should go into Hanukkah and bait this thing to do something or other. Let's see. Now, let's go into Blitzen. I'm gonna go into Blitzen and then double out into my... Hanukkah, and I really hope he just goes for the damn close combat or whatever. He might be weirded out by me doing this. He might see this play coming. I really hope he doesn't. It's kind of... I don't know. It's not that obvious. It's obvious to me because I'm making the play. But I don't know if it's obvious to him. So we're just gonna hope that Joba decides to fall for this. Come on. Just go for close combat. Don't go for knockoff. Don't go for anything. Don't go for earthquake. Just go for close combat. Fucking yes! Ah! The tailwind! Is it still up? How long does tailwind last? Oh god. Okay. Oh Jesus Lord. Okay. Alright. Okay. Okay. All right. Now we have to. I think we have to go into. Oh, we have to go into Christmas. I really didn't think the tailwind would still be there. I feel like it wasn't. Did it peter out? I don't know. I feel like. Oh god. Okay. Let's go into Christmas. And try and absorb an earthquake. As I really hope he's just gonna go for that. Either way, the tailwind must peter out at this turn. Goes for the stone edge, that's fine and dandy. Could have gone into my scrafty. Ah! Christmas! Okay, tailwind is gonna peter out. Now what we're gonna do is mega evolve and go for the... I don't think Leaf Storm will kill you. I don't think Giga Drain will kill you, rather. Unless it might. If it will kill him, then I'm gonna go for it. Unless Shadow Sneak just kills me. No, he's revealed all his moves unless he doesn't pack Psychic Stab. So let's just do a very quick calculation. So Mega Sceptile. Giga Drain. Let's see how much it does to a Mega Gallade. Cause if it can kill, then I am all down for that. So under most circumstances, it should kill, but I am so fucking wary that I'm just not going there. We're gonna go for the Dragon Pulse and hope that he doesn't have the Shadow Sneak. I don't think he does, just because he has Tailwind. I don't know why that tells me that, but it does. Oh fuck, please live. Come on, baby Christmas! Yes, Christmas is here! Christmas is here to stay! Yes! The motherfucking Gallade is dead. Yes! Christmas is here to stay! I'm just so happy if this team does anything. I'm just happy. First time I've tested it, by the way, so I don't know. Well, I feel super. So the Porygon Z, we're gonna be able to tell if it's scarfed if it outspeeds me, which will be incredible knowledge. But because it's called Die, I think it might be Specs. I'm actually really glad I went for Dragon Pulse. So, here is Dai. And, right, so here is Dai, and we need to break Dai. And if it has a scarf, we're gonna find out if it'll outspeed. So, we're just gonna go for a Leaf Storm for maximum damage, and we're gonna see if it'll outspeed me. If it does outspeed me, we will know that it's scarfed, and if it doesn't, then well, my friends, we can get a good hit on it with Leaf Storm. So we actually never mind. And it goes for the Psychic. Never mind. So Christmas Suit is going to faint, which is so unfortunate. And what we're going to do now, though, is we're going to go into Little Helper because he's... Is he locked into Psychic? I don't know. What are you? But I don't see a Life Orb, so I really do feel as though he is a Spec set. So what we're going to do is go for the knockoff because he can't stay in if he's locked in. And we're going to get a free knockoff. We're going to knock off the Golbat or the Cofagrigus. Either of these things are super. So, that's all right then. That'll be all right. Whew, I do hope that... I mean, the Leaf Storm, it could have been important, but, like, I'm so sick of bitching about hacks lately. It's just happening. So, okay, he's going to withdraw. I do feel that means he has choice... specs. Out comes Real Bulk. And we get a knockoff. Superb. So, I don't know if you want to go for Brave Bird or something. But we do have Zen Headbutt. So, we're just going to go for that. I kind of... Oh, Super Fang. Alright. We might actually have a chance of killing this thing then. So, let's go for the Zen Headbutt. Of course not. It's fucking Real Bulk. So... So, I think he's got to roost if he wants to live. So what I'm going to do is go into, let's see, is there anybody who can just wreck this thing? Well, my Blitzen is choice banded, but I can't lock myself into the normal, you know, normal move. I really want to preserve Little Helper. And I really strongly feel he's just going to roost. I need to preserve Little Helper because I need to, I don't know. No, you know what? We're just going to go for the Zen Headbutt again, I think. I think that's the best thing we can do. Let's just go for the Zen Headbutt once again. And try and maybe score a crit or something cheeky. Let's do it. Let's just go for the Zen Headbutt. I'm really glad I put Zen Headbutt on this thing now. And so he is going to, hopefully we can, I mean, he can creep, he can sort of keep creeping back, but if we can kill, I don't know. I need to get rid of this thing. Why am I so adamant on doing that? There is some kind of line of inquiry in my head, but I'm not sure why I'm following it. Whoopsie. Well, I mean, I don't know, he might switch into Cofagrigus. I would really like... You don't have Brave Bird, gee. I could have switched into a Chandler half an hour ago. Anyway, we're going to get the Zen Headbutt off, and that will kill Golbat. So so that's pretty good. I should have switched into a Chandler and then just destroyed everything with Flamethrower. But I'm really worried about this Cofagrigus. Come to think of it. Probably should have been a bit more careful. So, fuck. Damn. Ooh! Crap in a hat. What nature is my source book? You look like you're jolly. I need to quickly look at Porygon Z's speed because double dance? Porygon Z can be double dance? Is that a thing? Wow. Wow, I didn't know that was a thing. Let's see what speed... We should outspeed you because you are a funny spec situation, aren't you? So I don't really know what he's going to lock himself into or whatever. I just need to do some damage to this thing. I'm really upset, actually, that I... That was bad. I misplayed. I should have switched out. I should have switched into my Chandelure. I don't... Oh, that was really dumb of me. So Little Helper is going to faint. That's probably cost me the game, actually. I should have not done that. So he's going to lock himself into Ice Beam. And I'm going to go into Blitzen. Why did I do that? That was stupid. So he can honestly just go for Ice Beam right now. I'm going to go into Hanukkah because I really shouldn't have done that. We're going to go into Hanukkah because he's locked himself into Ice Beam. So I can, like, hit him. So I don't know why did I do that? Come on, concentrate. I'm choking right now. Silly. This shouldn't do over half. Good, it's a 3-hit KO. And now what we're free to do is go for the ye olde... we've got to go for Fire Blast. Please land it. Baby, yes you do! We are modest Chandelure, so... Yeah. We are modest Chandelure, okay. So if we can land this Fire Blast, it all depends on this now. If we can land this Fire Blast, then I can maybe win. But if I can't land this fire blast, I've lost. Oh, okay. Yeah. All right. Good. Amazing. Amazing. Okay. Well, that landing, that, I don't know. We might have still lost anyway. But it doesn't matter. Outcome's infected. So I don't really know the situation behind this thing. This thing's ability to. So we are Choice Scarf. We are Choice Scarf. I'm going to do, yeah, you guessed it, a calculation just to see if we even have a chance anyway. So Cofagrigus. What does a Shadow Ball do to you? Shadow Ball does so much damage, it's just unbelievable. So you're not going to flash fire me, you're just going to probably fire off a Shadow Ball of your own. So we're going to go into Blitz, and we need to switch up our moves because we're locked in right now. So let's just go into Blitz, and we just need to fire off some damage to this thing. And Blitzen is going to be unaffected. And now we are free to go for, well, we have to go for a Seed Bomb, but this is a Choice Banded Seed Bomb. Let's just see how much this does. We just need to weaken Cofagrigus to a point. My opponent's going to Will-O-Wisp. I don't care, I'm sacking Blitzen. I'm sacking Blitzen right now. So I'm completely, utterly fine with that. I just need to get enough damage on this thing. Putting it in range of my Chandelure, I'm, yeah. Unless I can somehow miss Seed Bomb. That's not bad. That's really not bad. I kind of expected a bit more damage from a Choice Banded thingamajiggy. Choice Banded Source Bug. But Blitzen, you have done your job. I'm so upset that Delibird didn't get to do anything. Delibird, the almighty Delibird. Shady Penguin, Jesus Christ. Why are you failing me right now? So we do manage... Oh, we get a crit. The useless crit. Which is actually making his Pain Split more potent. But it doesn't matter. I'm very sorry, folks, but we're actually just going to sit here and keep clicking Seed Bomb. How he's taking these Seed Bombs is leading me to believe that he is defensive, just because, you know, some kind of defensive investment anyway. I mean, to be honest, the Golbat was not taking Zen Headbutts very well from a non-stab Scrafty. I'm not invested. I am adamant. Pardon me, but I'm not invested, so. It's going to go for the Iron Defense. Iron Defense, Will-O-Wisp, Pain Split, Hex. I'm a bit scared now. I feel like I should switch out to my Chandelure right now. Oh, I do. No, we're just gonna go with Seed Bomb because I'm too pussy. Sorry. It's okay. As long as we do a little bit more than Lefty's restores, I'm fine. He can only get to plus 6 anyway, so. Ooh. You are scary, aren't you? Anyway, he can't do too much more damage. That was a perfect time for me to switch into my Chandelure, but we're just going to stay in Seed Bomb, and I really do hope that we can still take it out. I really do hope so. And we don't somehow miss Shadow Ball. Was that a crit? Oh my god. He's making it so these iron defenses don't matter. Blitzen, Blitzen. You are my guy. So this is honestly amazing because it guarantees that Infected stays within KO range of my modest Shadow Ball. Now, Chandelure's special attack is bananas. I've never really used one prior to Hanukkah, so this is honestly, it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. It's like a whopping base 145. Isn't that just ballistic? Anyway, if he has some special defensive investment, he might actually live. But from how he's taking the Seed Bombs, and it's not a resistance, mind you, from how he's taking Seed Bombs, the crit ones as well, which ignore my burn. Yeah, it's pretty crazy. So he is going for Hex, so he is trying. He is trying to get around Blitzen. I mean, yeah, to try and maybe hit my Chandelure if I choke again and go into my Hanukkah. Okay, now the moment of truth. Let's go for Shadow Ball. Happy Hanukkah! Yes! This is ironic because it's Christmas team, but represent anyway. So that is gonna be the game. Thank you so much for the challenge, Joba. Your team was scary as hell. So guys, do go and check out Joba's Twitter, which will be in the description, as it always is. I feel a weird paranoia that this isn't going to save, so I'm going to just fingers crossed that it doesn't, but I'm getting weird feelings, and you know you get weird feeling, you have to act on it. Anyway, I do hope you enjoyed this Christmas themed battle. Of course, leave your constructive criticism in the comments section. The team building video will have gone out before this. And they've been recorded on the same day. This is to stop any potential, I don't know. It's not really to stop any counter teaming, because I don't think that you guys would try that hard to counter team a Christmas team. unless you're actually the Grinch, in which case, cool. I played your video game as a child, it was very hard. Anyway, today's question of the day, ladies and gentlemen, is what is a Pokemon that you use that just never dies? In your experience, that never dies. You can always count on this Pokemon to take anything. We're gonna get 10 Umbreons, we're gonna get 20 Blisseys. Actually, Blissey use doesn't seem to be... I haven't seen that many Blisseys lately, so I wonder if it's dropped in popularity, but it's the only thing that can contest with the Greninja that well in OU nowadays. Me personally, oh my goodness. I'd like to say Umbreon. Umbreon is such a good Pokemon. In recent memory, Hippowdon. Hippowdon or Togetic, oh my goodness. Togetic in the right tier. Eviolite. That bad boy. Eggs Benedict. Benedict, my Togetic. Oh my goodness, he will just... how camp did I sound? Oh my goodness. No, he will mess you up. He's such a good wolf. And Hippowdon, I love Hippowdon very much. Hippowdon's just reliable, like Stealth Rocks. Sand if you want it, recovery, roar, just really good Pokemon. Anyway, yeah, answer in as much or as little detail as you like. Give me a few examples, but particularly what is your absolute favorite of all time? I do hope, I've probably said this 5 times, you enjoyed the Christmas team. I hope you're getting into the spirit. It's okay if you're not, but the most important thing of all is that you take care of yourselves, and I will see you soon, my friends. Bye-bye!